على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back to Tajweed Made Easy. This is your brother Abu Muhammad. In the last few lessons, we looked at the makharij al-huruf, where the letters are articulated from. Today, inshallah, we're going to start a new topic, which is the sifat al-huruf, the characteristics of the letters. We find out how the letters are pronounced. It is not enough to know where the makharij al-huruf are, to know where the places of articulation point are. It's very important to also know how we pronounce it. Because if we don't pronounce the letters properly, even if we take out from the correct makhraj, if we do not give it its correct characteristics, this letter might even change to another letter, or the least that can be said is that it's not going to be pronounced properly. So for example, if I say khalidina, khalidina, I've actually pronounced the kha from its correct makhraj, which is the top of the throat, kha, okay? But I've taken out from its correct makhraj, I mean, but I've not pronounced it properly. The Arabs used to pronounce kha with heaviness by elevating the back of the tongue. Kha, khalidina, khalidina, kha, instead of khalidina. If I say ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, I've taken out the ra from its correct makhraj, but I did not pronounce it properly. So we find out which letters are heavy, which letters are light. Find out which letters air flows with the letter, and which letters air does not flow with it. We find out which letters sound flow is it with the letter, and which letters sound do not flow with it, which letters have a nasalization sound, which letters have an echo sound, and so on, have an echo effect, the bouncing effect, and so on. Now I have here on the board sifatul huruf. Now we're going to summarize sifatul huruf. We're going to have a general overview what sifatul huruf is, and inshallah then we're going to go point by point in more detail, starting from the first two points today, inshallah. So we have here there's two groups. Sifat laha did, characteristics that have opposites. So these will come in pairs, okay? And the group of letters will be opposite to other group of letters. And sifat la did laha, characteristics that do not have opposites, these groups will just come individually. Inshallah, we're going to do most of them. And not all of them, but most of sifat la did laha. So if we start from here, sifat laha did, the first part is al-hams and al-jar. This is to do with air flowing with the letter and air not flowing the letters. Al-hams letters, there are 10 letters, inshallah we'll find out what they are. Whenever we pronounce these letters, air would flow with the letters. And the rest of the letters are al-jar. Air does not flow with the letters. We have here al-shidda, al-tawasut, and al-rahawa. Point number two is to do with the flowing of sound. A group of letters, because of their strength, the sound does not flow with them. A group of letters, because of their weakness, the sound flows with them. And a group of letters, the tawassut in the middle, the partially al-rakhawa, partially al-shidda. Okay, part of it we're going to make it flow, and other parts of it we're going to keep it in between the al-rakhawa and al-shidda. The third group is al-istifal and isti'la. This is to do with heaviness and lightness. Group of letters, the Arabs used to pronounce it heavily, in a heavy manner. In the group of letters, the Arab used to pronounce it lightly. And here, al-infitah and al-itbaq, this is the fourth group. This is to do with the tongue, some parts of the tongue. When we pronounce some letters, the sound, so some parts of the tongue, they will be compressed with the roof of the mouth. We'll find out which letters they are. So this is the sifat laha did, characteristics that have opposites. So they come in pairs and they're opposites of each other. Now, sifat la did, laha, characteristics that do not have opposites. Number one is as-safir. We'll find out the three letters. Naturally, when we pronounce these three letters, we would have a whistling sound whenever we pronounce these letters. We have here al-leen. Two letters, when they're in a certain situation, we pronounce it with softness, without pressure on the lips. We have here at-tikrar. This just means repetition. The only sifat that we're told not to do here. We'll find out there's a letter. If we don't pronounce it properly, okay, we'll be repeating that letter, so repetition. We have here at-tafashi. There's a letter that's got the characteristics of spreading. Whenever we say this letter, we have to do a sort of spreading. Shall we find out which letter this is? And we have here al-ghunna, two letters that whenever we pronounce these two letters, a nasalization sound would automatically flow through the nasal passage going down. And last one, we have al-qalqala, which means the letters that have a bouncing effect. Okay, whenever we pronounce these letters, when we're stopping these letters, there's a bouncing effect. So this is in a nutshell what sifatul huruf is. Inshallah, now we're going to look at the first two parts, al-hams and jahr, to do with the flowing of breath, and al-shidda, tawassut, and al-khawa, to do with the flowing of sound. So on the board here now, we have two types of characteristics. Number one, to do with the flowing of air. Number two, to do with the flowing of sound. So the first group here, this is al-hams, and opposite is al-jahr. Al-hams, just a group of letters, one group of letters, 10 letters. These letters, whenever we pronounce these letters, air should flow with these letters. Why? Because of the weakness in its origin. So how do we find this out? Whenever we pronounce this letter, fatha, kasra, dhamma, but with the sukoon will be clearest. For example, the first one is fa. If we put our hand in front of us, so try it, and say af, af, you feel that air flows with it. Same thing, ah, air would flow with it, ah. Then you have here, ath, ath. So whenever we pronounce these 10 letters, with the sukoon would be the clearest, air would flow with it due to weakness in its origin. The opposite side is the al-jahr groups, which is the rest of the letters. Air does not flow with the letter due to its strength in its origin. So the rest of the letter. So if I say, for example, ba, if you put your hand and say ab, ab, you notice no air will flow. Alt, air will not flow with it. There's a little amount because of breathing, okay, naturally, we find, but no significant amount will flow with it. These letters, you find significant amount of air flowing with it. So you probably ask, what's so special? Or what's the significance of knowing this? Basically, for example, letters of jahr, if we pronounce the letters of jahr with air flowing, two things would happen. Either that letter, it might change into another letter, or that letter will not be pronounced properly. For example, the ba, if I say ab, so try ab, you find no air flows, ab. But if I say the ba in a way that I put air flowing with it, so ab, ab, so bismillah, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, then I've changed the ba into a p in English. So this changes into another letter. Or ta, for example. Some people, whenever they pronounce ta, ta is from the letters that air does not flow with it. So min ash-shaytani, tani, you find no air flows in. But if I say min ash-shaytani, tani rajim, min ash-shaytani rajim, and make air flow with it, then the ta is not pronounced clearly, it's not pronounced correctly. So this is to do with the flowing of the air. Now here, next group, this is to do with the flowing of sound. Three groups of letters. Number one, ashidda, which means strength. Number two, tawassut in the middle, and al-rukhawa, the soft letters. The shidda letters are 10 letters. Ajidu qit bakat, okay? Hamza, jim, dal, qaf, ta, ba, kaf, ta. These letters, they're clearer when they're sukoon, but with fatha, kasra, dhamma, whenever we pronounce these letters, the sound of the letter stops. But with the sukoon will be the clearest. What do I mean by this? For example, ya'muru here. When we pronounce a letter that has the letter of the shidda letters, for example, has a sukoon, like ya'muru, the hamza has a sukoon. What we do is, we go right to the makhraj and come out straight away. So, ya'muru, ya'muru. So two things, remember two things. One, the sound, once we touch the makhraj, we let go. Ya'muru, ya'muru. And secondly, if you notice between the hamza and the next letter, the meem, if you notice, there's a gap. Ya'muru, ya'muru. Okay, it's not going to go and connect to the next letter straight. It's going to be pronounced, then little gap, then go to the next letter. So, ya'muru, ya'muru. Same thing. Takzeeb, takzeeb, touch the kaf. Takzeeb, takzeeb, takzeeb. The little gap between kaf and the next letter. Kaf and dal, takzeeb. These letters are called the ashidda letters. And this group is called at-tawassut now. At-tawassut just means in between ashidda and rakhawa. If ashidda, we just touch, let go, in the little gap, al-rakhawa would mean, would touch, then stay a little bit, and there's no gap between that letter to the next letter. So al-tawassut is in between. So there are five letters, which is lin-umar letters. There are lin-umar letters. Lin-umar just means soften Umar, because Umar's character was he was very stern. Okay, so lin-umar, soften Umar. These letters, when we touch the letter, we're not going to do like a shidda, touch, then let go. When we touch, we're going to touch, hold, then let go. Touch, hold a little bit, then let go. So here, alhamd will be alhamd. So lam here, from the lin umar letter, has a sukoon, alhamd, alhamdulillah. And we're not going to do like a shidda, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. Or else this is not giving its characteristic. It's got the characteristics of touch, hold a little bit, then let go. Alhamd. Same thing with the meem here, meem. Alhamdu, alhamdu, not alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, but alhamdu. Iyaka na'budu, na'budu. So this will be in between. So the first one will be touch and quickly let go. There's a gap between that and the next letter. This one will be partially touching and let go. So touch, then let go. So to touch, hold a little bit, then let go. And lastly here, we have al-rakhawa. Al-rakhawa are the remaining letters. These letters, whenever we pronounce these letters, once we touch the makhraj, once we touch the makhraj, we're going to hold a little bit and then pronounce the next letter. So, al-maghdubi, maghdubi, al-maghdubi. The ghain compared to the ayn, na'budu, na'budu, the ghain will be a bit longer. Maghdubi, maghdubi. So, similar to al-tawasit, but the flowing of sound will be a bit longer. So, al-maghdubi, al-maghdubi, al-maghdubi. And here, akhraja. And if you notice between ghain and the next letter, there's no gap. So, maghdubi, straight away, maghdubi, maghdubi. Whereas, ashidda, ya'muru, ya'muru. There's a little gap. Here, there's no gap. Here, there's gap. Here, there's no gap. Here, partially gap, partially no gap. So, these letters, the remaining letters are ar-rakhawa. So, three groups of letters. Ashidda, these the eight letters, these letters, sound does not flow with it. The opposite side here, ar-rakhawa, and the middle, at-tawasut. Inshallah, in the next lesson, we're going to start the huruf al-istifal and huruf al-istila, tarqiq and tafkhim.